We just made the image from the second floor, but I think it's extremely dramatic down here too. I'm going to take a very, very low camera position with myself sitting on the floor here in just a second. But let me talk about how I set up the shot. I want you guys kind of coming together about 45 degrees facing each other. So Charlie, come in a little bit more. Bring that foot in just a little bit more too. And another thing, since it's kind of a backlit, I like to tie the bride and groom together. So Charlie, I'm going to let you help her hold the bouquet. Just bring your hand right under the flowers too. Point the flowers out towards me like we've talked about in earlier videos so I don't see hands. And now, you know, it's interesting when many people have their, when they set the bride and groom up for a profile view, let me just show you. I want you guys to just turn shoulder to shoulder, looking right at each other. Just break the pose, even straight shoulder to shoulder. And now this is how a lot of photographers will do profiles of their brides and grooms. Now I'll ask everybody in the viewing audience, everybody here that's listening, you know, is this, now if you were thinking of telling your loved one, your bride, your husband, your wife, your bride, your groom, that you loved each other, would you ever be standing this way, telling them how much you care about them, how sincerely and how deeply you feel about them standing like this? Probably not. It's a hokey pose. Let's make it a little bit more natural. So I want to bring you guys together again, about 45 degrees. And this is exactly how I would do the full length of them in the church or wherever it might be in the park, just them looking at me. But how do we set up the profile? Let me have you guys just turn heads only towards each other, move away from each other just an inch or two. And here's a secret. I want you to just bring foreheads a little closer together, right like that. And that's the profile view. So their bodies are exactly the way they were in our regular portrait of the bride and groom, regular full length. So we just turn their heads only. And you know what? This is how people can talk with each other and tell each other how they feel about each other. So I think this is a much more believable pose. Let's finish up the description of this set of this particular image with how we set up our lighting. I'm going to let the lighting come from the back. I've got Erin, my assistant. The key thing here is she needs to be about 12 feet back. The flash is going to be about 4 feet off the ground. And most importantly, she has to get small and hide behind the bride and groom. I also want her to be pointing that flash at their shoulder blades. So I'm going to go ahead, get in position back here, click off a couple photographs and see what we can get. All right, I'm settled comfortably here on the floor. I have my wide angle at 10 millimeters, 10 to 22, a set of 10 millimeters right now. I've got this really neat looking hotel in the background. These guys are set up perfectly. Foreheads just barely, pretty close together, great. Let's just get image number one. We got our backlit flash. It should be on about quarter power or half power, but we're getting some really, really cool images. All right, so I'm just taking a couple more photographs, just zooming through the zoom range of the lens here from super duper wide angle. When I zoom in a little more closely, I get a different kind of a composition that I think looks pretty nice as well. And again, I'm going to have them just keep looking at each other, maybe the kiss, pull back apart, and then just really get a really cool series of images of them. The coloration, the tonality, the backlighting here is making for a wonderful looking image. Once I've got this done then, in a real world situation, I would finish up this. I would have my assistant come around since we have a cool setting right here. And let's just take more of a, just a traditional image of the bride and groom among the surrounds of their hotel where they're having a wedding reception. So let's go set that up next. I'm going to pull off one last photograph here in our last couple of seconds. A traditionally posed photograph of the bride and groom, again in the grandeur of their hotel. Erin is over here with the off-camera flash ready to go. Photograph number one, wide angle at the 10 millimeter setting. Cropping in here just a little bit more. Good, good, good. And I think we got a nice series of images. I want to make one quick point here, that whenever I'm using an off-camera flash, like Erin over here, she's in manual mode and I'm just ranging the power coming out of that flash from half down to quarter, down to eighth, down to 16th. Also, what is vitally important, and we actually had it up on the screen on the earlier lessons here, and off-camera flash and everything else, is that my camera is always on manual mode whenever I'm shooting a flash. Like 99% of the time, it's always on manual mode. That gives me the opportunity to range my shutter speed to control the background of the scene that I'm shooting in. So anyway, just in this little part right here, in these last couple minutes, we got some really, really cool photographs of a bride and a groom. I want to thank you guys a bunch. Thanks.